are you expecting the word of God today? How much are you spending Sundays when you are coming to church? I believe that you are not just simple, just coming to church or following friends here to church. I'm sure that you are coming here because you have that desire of listening to God's word. And through that word, I believe that your life will start to change. I really pray that through today's service, you can confirm the answers that you need for your life. Depending on how much are you expecting of this word, you will receive also that much grace, and that grace will start to work in your life. But indeed, this last week, our pastor gave us the word, look at God's working. According how did you hold onto this message, I'm sure that you was able to receive answers in the field. You was able to see how God is working, not only in your life, but also with the people around you. If you are able to see how God works, everything will be finished for you. Because you have a secret. Everything or other things that other people cannot see, you will start able to see. What other people cannot do, you will start to be able to do it. Why? You have a secret. You have Jesus Christ with you, you have God with you, and you know how God is working. So you can become completely a different person. Also, if you are able to see how God works in the field, the people around you also will start to become safe, will start to receive strength from you. They really want to be near or next to you. Why? Because you will be a blessing also for them. This is how God works, and how God works also through all of us, those of who are enjoying the gospel. Then, if you are able to see how God is working in the field, why problems are coming to me, you will be able to understand this. Why problems are coming to us? In that way, because problems come to us, we can make a new conclusion or resolution again inside of Jesus Christ. If problems come to us, we can be a witness and check that there is no other way except the gospel, except Jesus Christ. So we will be able also to see that when I live separate, when I live without knowing God, when I live without focus my life into God, there is no solution for me. If it's not like that, I go inside of one thing. I want to talk about this today. If I'm not focused my life a little bit into the gospel, if I'm not able to check how God is working in the field, my life will go inside of the absolute impossible flow. We must understand that if it's not because the gospel in my life, everything is going to become impossible. Without reason, I don't know why, but it looks like everyone is going against me. I don't know why, I try to be kind with other people, but I don't know why it looks like all the people around to me, they're going against me. I don't know why, this reason. I don't know why, even I come in church or pray, but I cannot see how God is answering me. We must be able to see God's work, but I don't know why, I don't know God's work. I cannot see that. There is believers who have been going to church for a long time. There is something that we must be careful. If I'm not able to check the pulpit message in my life, if I'm not able to see the answer that God is giving me through the pulpit message in my life, my work of faith will become really comfortable way. And I'm not talking in the comfortable way as a good thing. I mean, like, I just come in church and go, and during the week forget about it and not able to see or realize answers that God is already giving to me. You must be able to check one thing, the word of God. The word that is given to you from the Pope message. This is the most important thing. Especially those who have doing the work of faith for a long time. If you're not able to check this answer that is come to you through the Pope message, you must think about it. Today, our sister Tembi also prayed, God, let us listen your voice, or lead also our pastor Tony, that preach whatever you are telling to us. Speak through him, right? We pray a lot about this. If really God is talking to you through the Pope message, it's gonna tell you something really important, right? Something that you need for your life. Think about it. If I'm God and I'm just going to tell you on Sunday, I make appointment with you. I will meet you this Sunday, and I will tell you what you need. God is telling you that. If you are coming to the worship with this kind of heart, the word that you are listening is different. Why? The word that you're receiving is the word that you need for the week. Not also for the future week, but also inside there, you can find the answer that you need from the last week also. So during the worship, you can be able to understand, and you can be able to check the answers that you already received. If you're able to do that, this impossible flow, it changes to a possible flow. So we can check that there is these two flows in the field, even in our lives. If I pray, even I pray, I cannot see the answers. You must know this today. I don't receive answers or blessings just because you are praying or just because you are coming to church. Are you reading the flow of the word? Are you reading? Are you really inside of prayer? Your heart, yourself, is reading inside of evangelization? Then why am I not able to see the answer that God prepared for me? Why am I not able to see or discover the blessings that God is giving to me? It's not that God is not giving me. I'm inside of an impossible flow in my life. This is my spiritual state. My spiritual state is, I have a spiritual state that I cannot see God's answer. Doesn't mean that God is not giving to you the answer. Doesn't mean that God didn't prepare the blessings to you. My spiritual state is a spiritual state that everything becomes impossible. So how can I change that? I will talk about this later here. If you just ride the flow, being in prayer with the world, and also put your life inside of evangelization, you will be realized that inside of this is everything in your life. If I have a state, from that moment, if I'm inside of this, I will have a state to receive the answers, to see the answers also. This is happening because why I cannot see the answers, or why I cannot see the work of God, is happening for one reason. My spiritual state is not inside of this. It's inside of other things. So this is the reason why I cannot see how God is working. If we read today's Bible verse, Acts 5:42, day after day, in the temple, courts, and from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the gospel, the good news, that Jesus is the Christ. Day by day, house to house, every day. Every day you will be able to see this kind of works. But for us, it's really difficult even to see just one day, right? Even just, if I can tell just one answer that I received from last Pope message. Can you do that? Oh, last week, Pastor was talking about this. And on Wednesday, for example, or on Thursday, I received this answer according to the word. I'm not talking about, oh, I was praying for pass my exam and I passed my exam. Sometimes even we don't pray for pass the exam, we also do. I'm not talking about this kind of answers. Also, that's answers, but I'm not talking about that kind of answers. Oh, the pastor was talking about this I hold on to this message. I pray in that way, and God fulfilled that word. This kind of answers. I was praying last week, God, let me become a witness of the world evangelization. Let me become a witness of evangelization movement that arise in the book of Acts, day by day, in house to house. Every day, I really pray that you become a witness of the work of God in your life. How can I do that? Are you seeing, confirm just these three things? Just check this into your life, make it yours, and then it will be everything. Every day, you will be able to receive answers. If you cannot see this, everything, or every day, it is because you don't have this spiritual state. So pray to God and just go inside of this. This is the power or the key to change the flow in my life. This is why Pastor said last week, don't just enjoy salvation, but also enjoy the content of salvation. Because we believe in Jesus Christ and we accept Him, we become child of God, we become saved people, right? All people that are here have already received salvation. This salvation never disappeared. This salvation, it was given to us as a gift by our faith. And it's going to be with us, for us, forever. No one is going to take that salvation. But what you must understand, don't just enjoy the fact that you are saved and you are a child of God. Also enjoy the contents. In other words, enjoy the meaning of salvation. What it means for you. I saw many people, they believe in Jesus Christ, they accept Him. From that moment, they completely change their destiny. They become child of God. They become saved. Even they never come to church even at least once, it's okay. When they die, they will go to heaven. For one reason, because they just believe in Jesus Christ. But if you look at their lives, they are living like in the hell. Of course, when they die, they will go to heaven. They are going to be much better. But in this earth, completely going their life inside of suffering, mental problems, or fighting with the husband or the wife, it looks like they're living into the hell. Their life, their face, their expression is really hard and suffering. It's really sad to see them. It's really sad to see that kind of saved people. What it means? Enjoy the contents or the meaning of salvation in your life. It means that this salvation is not just going to heaven. It means that you can enjoy it even today. What that means? It means that because you are saved, the problem of Satan completely finished in your life. What it means, you don't need to suffer anymore because Satan or because demon wars. Why? You have the authority over Satan. In the name of Jesus Christ. It means that the problem of sins, the problem of hell, that background, completely finished on you. This is the meaning. It means that I'm free from this, but if I'm enjoying the content of salvation, also from me, many people also can be saved. That's the meaning of salvation. If you have this answer with you, that is Jesus Christ, people around you will start also to receive salvation. Every day, every day. This week, two people accepted Jesus Christ. That's yesterday, also one Chinese girl, some of you also know, accepted Jesus Christ in the Dharapan. She just came, and we were sharing the gospel to her, and she believed she accepted Jesus Christ. Means becomes free from this. On Monday, our Kangi young brother also accepted Jesus Christ in his heart and become child of God. Forever, he become free of all of this. I didn't do nothing, just go share the gospel. What happened? It was next, and was in God's hands. What I want to say, I'm not just enjoying salvation for myself. Don't be that much selfish. If you are able to enjoy this a little bit, God, through you, will start to save many people. Will start to save many people. God has a plan for your life and wants to use you for world evangelization, to save your family, to save your region. I really pray you can really enjoy the content of salvation. Just a little bit that you can enjoy this, and God will use you. Doesn't matter which kind of person you are. Doesn't matter what you have, how much grades you have, what is your studies, or who are you, from which country are you come from. Doesn't matter. The most important thing, if you are inside of this a little bit, God use any person. Doesn't matter which kind of person. Today we must look at God's own working. How can we do that? How can we check that through the world? How can I be a witness of God's working? Don't do other things, just experience. The power of the gospel. If this power becomes mine, what will happen next? From that moment, darkness around to me disappeared. From that moment, curses that come from my family line disappeared. From that moment, disasters or problems that come to my family start to disappear, become solved. The only thing that you need is to experience the power of the gospel. Why? The gospel has this power. No in other name, but only in the gospel of Jesus Christ. The only thing that you must need to see God's works is to experience the power of the world. I did nothing, but I just was sharing the word of Jesus Christ. The person completely changed their destiny. That is it. You must experience this. I did nothing, I was just sharing the word of God. People's life started to change. People who go into depression completely go away from the depression. I just fall a little bit onto the world and share it, and amazing things is happening. It's the power of the world. If you are missing the pulpit message, means you are missing the most important thing. The gospel is the word of God. The power of the word is inside also on the message. So then you will be able to see that all the fields start to change. That all the fields start to become safe, even through you. I really want you to make a new conclusion also into your life. Today, don't just listen to God's word, listen just God's voice. So which kind of words of God will arise? I would like to experience this with you together. Already, we are doing with some of you. Me, myself, with all of you, we will become a witness of the words of God. By teams with your team leader and all the members just gathering in the field, in front of your school, in front of your workplace, and praying together and check the world. What are we going to do? We are just going to check how God is working, how we will do it, confirming the word, confirming the public message. I know it could be difficult to you if you cannot understand really well, or if you cannot hold on to nothing still of the public message. But I believe if we are gathering here a little bit and holding on to the public message, that God will fulfill that public message. Even non-believers will start to come, like this week. I experienced this twice. Why non-believers are coming? To receive salvation. Day after day, in the temple courts, and from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus is the Christ. This is the amazing words that God is doing. So together we will establish this kind of a system in the field, before or in front of your school, in front of your house, in front of your workplace. We will see how God works every day through our lives. I really pray that you will become a witness. So what kind of words will arise? We are praying from 300 acceptance. Not praying for other things, but to raise this kind of system around Otegu to save the multi-ethnic. Let's raise just 30 systems for evangelization. Bible promised to give us the answer of 3,000 disciples. Of course, the numbers are just numbers. But I believe that God will start to arise this kind of works in the field. Why is God's desire? Day by day, in house, in every each house. I really pray that we can become this kind of witness. I pray. Dear God, thank you for your grace. Let us be inside of your word, the prayer, and evangelization day by day. God, put our lives inside of the flow that everything is possible. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.